as it lived on from Chippewa down up the big lake they call Gajigami. The lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. The good ship and crew was a bone to beat you when the gales of November came early. It was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the North Wind they'd been feeling? Well, the wind and the wires made a tattletale sound, and the wave broke over the railing. And every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. Oh, the dawn came late, and the breakfast had to wait, when the gales of November come slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain, and the face of a hurricane west wind. When supper time came, the old cook came on deck, saying, "Fellas, it's too rough to beat you." At 7 p.m. the main hatchway caved in. He said, "Fellas, it's been good to know you." Oh, the captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew were in peril. And later that night, when its lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. The waves turn minutes to hours. Searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay, they'd put 15 more miles behind her. Oh, they might have split up, they might have capsized, they may have broke deep into the water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives, the sons, and the daughters. Lake Huron rolls, Superior sings in the rooms of her ice-water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams, the islands and bays of a sportsman. And farther below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November remember. In a musty old hall in Detroit they prayed, in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. Oh, the legend lives on from the Chippewa down up the big lake they call Gajigami. It's a peerless that never gives up her debt when the gales of November come early.